What is the worst crime of the Oval Office? Well, excluding what Bill did to Monica Lewinsky, remembering he did not have sexual relations, I won't speak on the current president and the Republican nominee, but in the new Democratic Party, the White House was occupied by a chimpanzee. He started out cute and cuddly in appearance and tried to speak everyone's language, but I've listened to you and Bobby, it doesn't matter what they tell me, we have been here before. Bill Clinton, was and still is, a wild animal with a domestic side. We quickly learned his true identity. He turned and the true identity quickly came out, while in office, although he was elected only on his friendliness by kissing babies, shaking hands. He ended his term being known more for groping women. When he got into office, he didn't know what to do first, so once there, in his boredom, he jumped around and had to try out and mess with everything. He was not content, he did not want to waste the opportunity to be himself, so when the true Bill eventually came out, he had already tore up the office, slung poo everywhere and put everyone, not like him, in compromising positions. He would eventually leave office, but only after destroying everything and leaving the place only recognizable by the sign on the door in the shape of the office. The rest, well, for the rest, it was left a complete zoo and in shambles. He promised to see himself out, but, and only after, reminding everyone how criminal his family really was. The best example, if my internet research, interest and memory is accurate, the Clinton stole all dinner furnishings to include the plates, bowls, and serving trays, all in fine china, the solid gold presidential diningware and utensils. Additionally, Hillary stole the bedding, every towel, and the presidential bathrobes, marked with the White House presidential seal, monogrammed on the back. They should not, however, gotten their security deposit back.